What's up, guys? Hamsterwheel here with a new video, and we are once again back. We meaning me, Dr. Nomad, and Connor is here, kind of too. His pet. There we go.
Yeah, he's here in spirit.
Yeah. Rip Connor. Rip.
He died after he saw the new Superman and Batman movie. After he saw the reviews for it, he's like, no.
R.I.P. Connor, 69420. Good night, movie, sweet prince.
This movie just has to be good.
So yeah, we're here and we're doing Sethekk calls now. We're still with the same people, by the way. So shout out to those guys for sticking around. We appreciate that.
Thanks for doing that, guys.
Yeah.
Thanks for not being lame and leaving.
So, well, to be fair, if they left us, like we wouldn't really blame them.
Yeah, to be fair, that's a good assessment of the situation.
It's good that we haven't like told them that I haven't told them like, oh, I have a YouTube channel. It's like, oh my god, you and 4 million other people, and that YouTube
right.
that you click. Because if we would have told them that, they would have been like, fuck these guys, let's get out of here, cringeworthy assholes. But no,
I'm putting this video on YouTube, guys. You're famous.
By the way, guys, I have a Kickstarter and I have an Indiegogo where I'm asking for money for a new gaming PC, which I need to stream because I'm 12 and I don't have any fucking money. I actually watched the very first Back to the Future when I was in Germany. It was freaking amazing.
How long ago was that? Was that when you went to Germany a few weeks ago?
It was like last week, actually, I went to Germany.
You'd never seen it before that?
Yeah, of course I did, but it was like, right. I watched that as a kid, and now I watched it again, and I was like, holy shit, all these things you didn't notice as a kid, because you're a kid.
Right. And are you waiting for the inevitable reboot of that?
Oh my god. Oh, are you like making, is that a hint towards new Ghostbusters?
You mean Cuntbusters? What a fucking joke. Oh my god.
You know what? I don't really I'm not bothered by the idea of three female characters playing.
I am.
But it's the fact that it just comes over as they did that on purpose.
Oh, that's no, they made a foolproof movie. So yeah. If you badmouth it, you're sexist. Even if it's bad, you're badmouth
Oh yes.
Basically, if you badmouth it, you're sexist.
Yeah, that.
Even if the movie legitimately sucks.
Yeah. But isn't that with anything? Isn't that with, like, everything you criticize? Oh god, we pulled too much. And we're gonna die.
Oh, we are gonna die. Run!
I'm stunned. Oh wait, I'm stunned on purpose. I don't know why he, like. Okay, I
how did you not die?
Because I have divine intervention.
Can you, like, res me?
I have combat rest, but I'm not gonna use it on this one though. I should save that for when we're actually needed during a boss.
Okay, how do I get back?
Oh god. Like go to the center of that giant stadium and then just fall down and.
Right. Okay.
Alright, guys, we wiped. That was unfortunate. We accidentally pulled too much shit, basically. So, yeah, we're going to try again. Anyway, we were talking about Ghostbusters. Yeah.
Yeah.
The ever so awesome movie. And I, you know what? I want to like, I know it's going to be horrible, but it's going to be one of those things where I'm like, I got to see how horrible it is so I can make fun of it. That kind of thing.
Right.
So, yeah, that's going to be it for me.
Right. Well, you know, it's probably going to be as bad as the Warcraft movie. So I hope the Warcraft movie is going to be good. I want it to be good.
Me too, but
I don't want the movie to fail.
It's the same with me. I expect it to be bad, so I don't want to get hyped over like literally anything anymore, because then like it'll just be a disappointment, because you'll have these extremely high expectations. Like I want to get hyped about the Warcraft movie. I want it to be like super amazing and everything, but for some reason I'm thinking it's just going to be a decent popcorn movie, like a.
And that's right.
It, I think. Okay, I think.
But again, like going back to Ghostbusters, who is this fat white bitch? Why do people think this fat white cunt is so funny?
I don't know.
She's in that movie, Tammy. And again, like I said, the only people that think this woman is funny are these unattractive, middle-aged housewives. and they go see these movies with their cunt girlfriends, and this woman's allowed to have a career for it. You know, fuck old Hollywood. Fuck people like John Wayne, Gary Cooper, you know, people with talent. You know, it's all about Tammy. You know,
you think it's white bitches. You think it's hip to please... Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We're getting
wrecked.
Son
of a bitch. We're wiping again?
No, it's fine.
Ah!
Okay, it's fine. It's fine. Kill that one. Kill that one. I got it. Guy, get out. There we go. I got him.
Okay. Oh, fuck.
Let me heal you up.
That was close.
Okay, I'm gonna heal up the guy. Damn it. Okay, he died.
Oh,
it's
man.
Fine. It's fine. I got him. Just keep me alive. So, yeah. See, I told you this is gonna be a lot harder than the first one.
Right.
These mobs, I remember now, they silence. No.
Oh, fuck. We can get this one. Come on. Got him. We just have a bird.
Yeah, two birds. Alright, guys, we're back. Third time's a charm, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, I hope.
Well, we just gotta stay back. I mean, the problem we're having is that we're staying very close to the tank, so we just gotta stay back.
Right.
Alright, so, we were talking about the Ghostbusters movie, right? What
we were talking about that fat white cunt.
Yes, that way, I don't know.
That bitch.
You know
that
what?
Bitch from
family. I don't think I've ever seen her in any other movie, so I'm not sure if she's funny.
She was in that god awful movie, Tammy. She was in that Jason Statham comedy.
Was she in that one movie where her and some pretty girl were being cops and everything?
I don't know if that was the same fat white bitch.
Yeah, because that fat white. That one was quite funny, actually. She was okay. I thought she was okay.
They might be funny because some clever Jew wrote them a funny line. No offense to Jews. I'm not trying to be anti-Semitic here.
No. You can make.
Even though I totally just was, but
as we have seen in the world, you can make fun of Jews. That's okay.
Right. You just can't make fun of Muslims, right?
I forgot. Right.
Anyway, because somebody wrote her that line, you know, and after six takes of her stealing food from behind the scenes. She finally summed up the courage to do a half-decent take, and that's what they went with. So sick of this fucking lie that's been spun that women are funny. Sarah Silverman is funny. No, she's not.
Honestly, if I look at, like, the only, like, stand-up comedian I might find kind of funny that is female is, like, probably, like, Amy Schumer. I think she's all right.
Oh, I hate that Cabbage Patch Kid bitch. She looks like a fucking Cabbage Patch Kid.
I don't care. Like I don't.
She
yeah,
is
I don't think
so
she looks,
ugly.
I don't
and
care.
So fat.
She is at least kind of funny and somewhat witty compared.
You
to,
know
like,
who's funny?
No.
Bill Burr.
Oh God, yes.
Richard Pryor. Excuse me. Louis C.K. Bill Hicks.
Yeah,
George
I mean,
Carlin.
I know,
real comedians.
I know, but like when you have to look at like female stand-up comedians, out of all the ones I've seen, like Amy Schumer is not bad. I'm
but
not
she's
saying
so
she's really
fat.
Funny.
She's so fat, Hamsterwheel.
She's fat?
Amy Schumer is fat. Uh-huh. I'm going to be... What is this? What's going on?
We're doing the boss.
Oh, we are? Okay, sorry. No, I mean, look, dude, if you think she's funny, more power to you. I'm not going to knock you for that. You know, because there's shit I like that you can't stand, probably. You know, that's cool, but... You know, my opinion, this is my subjective opinion.
Okay, yeah.
This is just my opinion.
Yeah, okay.
If she died in a car wreck tomorrow, I wouldn't feel too bad.
Okay, I do not share that opinion, but... Yeah, but to be fair, I agree, like, comedians such as Louis C.K. and Bill Burr and one of my favorites, Patrice O'Neill, which is unfortunately
oh,
not
Jesus
with him anymore.
Christ, I love Patrice O'Neill.
Yes. Oh wow. Oh, I already have those. Huh.
I don't need it.
Anyway, I remember he was on Opie and Anthony. You probably have that there in America, right? That's where it is actually, of course.
Opie and Anthony?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, until Opie bitched out and Anthony had to leave the show.
I heard about that. Basically Patrice O'Neill was like, you know, like you can basically write pretty much any comedian can write 30 minutes of very funny stuff. But it takes a whole new level of being funny to go like be third chair on a radio show and then just come up with funny stuff on the spot.
And be the glue that holds everything together for the show.
And
just, which it was. Yeah. Because I considered the opening Anthony show. Anytime Patrice was on, it was the Patrice and Anthony show, not Opie. You know, because Opie really didn't add much to the show.
I agree. Yeah, I know.
He still doesn't, you know. And you can say whatever you want about Jim Norton, like he's a loudmouth, small little, you know, prick. But at least he can be funny sometimes.
Yeah, I agree.
He can be. Unlike Opie, who's just sort of sitting there talking about his hot wife. So, you know, what the fuck.
Yeah. But basically, that's what I'm trying to say. Like, it's very... it's hard to be on a radio show and just come up with funny stuff right on the spot. And if you can do that, that's a sign of a true comedian, if you can do that. And Patrice was on Opie and Anthony a lot, and he added so much funny stuff to the whole show. That's why I loved him so much.
His prison story, all that stuff. Like, it's just really good.
Look up Patrice O'Neill on video games and Patrice O'Neill on Asian people. Those are the two funniest rants I've ever seen in my life.
The Asian one's really funny. But also also check out Patrice O'Neill Tells His Prison Story. Mm-hmm. That one's really good too.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, I'm going to get wrecked. Use volley. There we go.
I did.
Yeah, excellent.
Yeah.
We're doing... Well, we still need to play the game. How the hell did I... I remember. I still need to get used to... like, it's been a while since I've played on the Phoenix server.
Right.
And bear tanking on Primal is very different. It's much easier, basically. So
how is Primal going? You're still playing on there?
Yes. Are you still, like, leveling there occasionally?
I've been busy. I've been playing Morrowind for a month straight. I'm going to be honest with you, dude. I've been playing Morrowind for a month straight.
God damn, you should play on Primal, man. I need more, like... I need more people there that I know. Basically.
Dude, no, seriously, if you want me to play on Primal, I'll play on Primal. Like I said, it's time I start getting back in the WoW anyway. I gotta make some more content for my channel.
You can, like, join, like, Molten Core and ZG, because that's, like, they kind of, like, nerfed it to where it's, like, I want to say it's easy, but it's pretty casual. So you can just join our guild and just do that casually. You can hang out with people.
Oh, wait, this guy's fighting.
Why did you feel the need to type in chat you have boots?
Well, he said R.
R?
I had to respond with something. You think I'm just going to be rude and not say anything?
So instead you're rude and say that you're...
You think I'm an asshole?
Yeah, you're an AIDS hole.
You're an AIDS hole. We didn't do too bad.
Okay, so when this guy, like, teleports, you got to get out of his line of sight. That's all you need to know. You think you can do that? Huh?
What am I supposed to do? I was paying attention to Sarah Jessica Parker over Screech.
Oh my god. 1 second.
Who are we?
Ja, ik ben nu even bezig. Wacht even. Over een minuutje.
Ich weiden.
Alright, let's continue. Let's kill this crew quick. I need to go downstairs and actually help my dad with something with a guitar.
All right, let's...
I think it's broken. Anyway, let's move.
What am I supposed to do?
So basically, when he teleports, you gotta get out of his line of sight. So move behind the pillar or something.
Right.
So just stand here, and if he teleports to us, just run around the corner, and that's all you need to do. But it's pretty easy because it's normal, and we do a lot of DPS, so we should be fine.
Molly.
I need to stop real quick before I over aggro.
Let's get him. You're gonna get cucked, bird. You're gonna get cucked.
I'm so close on his threat. Oh, yeah, run around. Ah! Run around the corner. Run around the corner. It's fine. I can't even get that high with my fucking voice. Where is he? I got him. There we go. We got it. Oh, you died? Oh,
I died.
Rip. It's fine. We got him. There we go. We got him.
Res me.
Oh my god, Dr. Nova, you're so damn lucky. Get both of those. They're really good. Need on that shit.
Release me. One of them won.
Oh yeah, that's the druid. Cause, yeah, it's fine. It's decent it's cool. Tanking gear. It's
yeah, it's good decent. For him.
All right, so that's pretty much it. I think we're done.
There's a treasure chest.
Yep, you can get a key.
Ahoy, mateys.
Oh my god. I'll end the video here because I need to figure out what the hell is going on downstairs. So once again, guys, it was another dungeon run. We might do a few more in the future. We're not sure. But anyway, this was Sethekk Halls. Once again, Dr. Nomad, thanks for joining me in this cringe fest 2016. That's basically what it was, right?
Well, you know, I appreciate you even having me. You know, I think at the end of the day, what we both need to agree on is fuck Movie Mom.
Yep. All right, guys. We'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye-bye.